Savior's love I live because he is risen. La 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 la. I live to tell what the Lord has done. I live to sing of my Savior's love. I live because he is risen. La 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 la. The day the Lord has made, I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day the Lord has made.
Pray the Lord my soul to keep. Mama told me just believe. Build your life on one true thing. The foolish man built on sin. A house like that won't ever stand. The winds will rage and storms will end. But I'm gonna be a different man upon this rock. Hell don't stand a chance. Heaven's got my back. This house is built to last upon this rock. My hope and confidence, my strength and soul defense. My faith was built for this.
Church Kids Show.
Hey everyone, and happy almost Valentine's Day.
Almost. Hey, I've got a really good joke about Valentine's Day. You want to hear it?
Am I allowed to say no?
Nope. Let me get my glasses
then
on.
Then sure.
Emma! Let me get my mic ready.
Oh, that wasn't it. Sorry. I thought that was the...
What did the man with the broken leg tell his Valentine?
My leg is broken. I don't know.
I've got a crutch on you! Get it? A crutch! Because he's using a crutch. I don't know why he turned British, but he did.
You're a wizard, Harry.
For today's game, we are playing Relationship Love Song Charades.
Relationship Love Song Charades. I'm trying to think of how that works.
Stuck in this chair.
I know what charades is. I know what love songs are.
Okay.
I know what relationships are.
Got it.
How do you?
All right.
I am curious.
We will take turns drawing a song title from the bowl, and we will act it out without speaking. The other person must guess the song, and within, 10, 15 seconds, I don't know.
10 to 15?
Like a reasonable amount of time. And then whoever guesses the most correct wins.
So without, can you move your mouth and, like, word?
No, you cannot.
All right.
Are we ready?
I'm ready. I guess I'm going first,
because
I reached
go
my
hand. Go ahead. We just can't take forever. It's
okay.
Really the goal
this
here.
Is a long piece of paper for.
I mean, it's.
Oh.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm ready. Go. You, me, love. You, me. Oh. Okay. Tarzan. Is it Tarzan? Okay. You. Oh. You'll be in my heart. Yes, you'll be in my heart.
I thought it was you'll be in my heart. Is it not?
I don't think so.
I watched that movie a lot, but correct.
My heart.
Well done. I get a point.
It has to say in.
I get a point, right?
No, I get a point. Okay.
That's a love song.
Focus. Okay. Okay. Ready?
Heart. Love. Love. One another deeply honors that. Love. Love is an open.
Yeah!
Door!
Love is an open door.
Hold on, I think I can do it better this time, right? Love is an open door.
It's 1-1, a tie.
1-1, 1-1.
Go,
one to one.
go. Okay. What is going on?
I don't know how to like.
E.T. Binoculars. Here I stand in the world. You.
We're getting somewhere.
Is it world? Am I right with world? Okay. No. What? And I have no idea. Oh my gosh.
It is a whole
world.
But I'm way up here. It's crystal clear. But now I'm in a whole new world.
Okay, it was pretty good. It was good.
Okay.
What?
Sneak. Lion. Oh, there's only one love song in Lion King. And now all I can hear in my head is Jesus is my friend. I'm scared. Hakuna Matata.
Yeah, yes! Good job!
Oh, that's not a love song.
It's not. That's why I was so kidding. I'm shocked that I was able to act that out well enough for you to guess it.
I was like, spider or?
Horns. Baby Jesus. A baby, and a lion. What is going on? I can't breathe. I don't understand that. Blinking. Oh, is it a lion?
Huh?
Is it a lion? Are you a lion? Oh, I have no clue. Tarzan monsters. Jesus, the story of Jesus. I cannot tell it all, but you are. Oh, Beauty and the Beast!
Yes!
Whoa! Was that the rose in the jar?
That's the rose and the beast.
But what was this?
Beauty, the... Well done.
Great job. You win. I took way too long. I just really thought that
so
was
I get a
hilarious.
Point.
No.
Oh.
You
okay.
have two and I have one. Like,
You've
you win
it.
The game.
I win the game. Yeah!
Okay, well, time for you to play a game. So, bye!
This town ain't big enough for the two of us.
What's up, church kids? We're about to get into a game that I like to call Water World. All right, so the point of this game is you are gonna have one squirt gun, all right? And then your opponent is gonna have one squirt gun. So that means there are two people on the stage. And then what you gotta do is you have got to shoot your squirt gun at the target right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Solo. You have 10 cups to knock down off the table, but you have to line up behind the designated line. No cheating here, because we have Sheriff, and he's in town, and he's ready to rock. Get your trigger finger ready and your water on, because we're about to get into Water World.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Romans 12 saying love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Romans 12:10. It's our time to love one another. Loving everyone as if they were your brother or your cousin or your sister or your neighbors too. Look them in the eyes and tell them we love you. But love is more than words, so make sure you show them. Go to extra mile and watch they might be blowing. You can give them a gift or ask them how are you, or think of how to help them when they seem real blue. Our love should be deep, yes, deeper than the ocean. So right now, let's put that into motion. If you can love a pet, why not anyone you met? Got the biggest love in that, but also don't forget. Honor up, down, all around in a giant circle. I be shouting honor till my face be turning purple. The word, though, is my spiritual thermal. I'm verbal and honor like my Jesus the Eternal. So recap, we have to love and honor. For that is the heart of our son and father. Nice job, well done, now we reached the end. Let's go back, repeat Romans 12:10. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Romans 12:10. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Love one another deeply. Honor others more than yourself. Romans 12:10.
Church. Church Kids! This month we are talking all about peer relationships, and part of relationships is resolving conflict.
Ooh, boy, conflict.
Yep. Conflicts are hard. All relationships have disagreements. My best friend and I used to argue a lot. But what's even harder is having grace.
You know, that is so true, Tracy. And one biblical story that shows us forgiveness is the story of Joseph and his brothers. His brothers were terrible to him, and they even tried to kill him. But even after the mistreatment he faced, Joseph forgave his brothers.
Joseph's story teaches us the importance of forgiveness and how it can lead to healing in relationships.
So, Tracy, what would you say the steps are to resolving conflicts with grace?
Oh, boy. The first step is to listen. What is the other person trying to say?
Absolutely. When we listen with an open heart and mind, we can better understand the other person's feelings and needs and even find common ground.
The next step is to seek forgiveness and show grace. Just as God forgives us when we mess up, we should be willing to forgive others even when it's difficult.
Ooh. That's not easy, Tracy.
You're right, but God can help us show grace and even admit our mistakes and apologize when necessary. And finally, asking God for help is the final step. Through prayer and reading our Bible, we can find the strength and guidance we need to navigate difficult relationships.
So good. The Bible tells us in Romans 12:10 to love one another deeply, honor others more than yourself. Relationships can be hard, but they are so important. Well, now, let's take a look at our lesson today.
What's going on?
Tony's outside checking the road conditions.
We're worried that the roads might be too icy for us to go home.
What will we do if we can't leave?
Just be happy the power isn't out. Last time we were snowed in, it was a lot chillier around here.
Tony! How's it looking out there? Were you able to drive your car?
In a manner of speaking.
What does that mean?
My car slid into a ditch. I think we're stuck here, guys.
This should be fun.
My name is Harper, and this is the time we learn to be loyal friends.
We're really stuck here? What's gonna happen to us?
Don't worry about it, Jake. We'll just find something to do while the storm passes. Do we have any postcards?
Nope, it's empty.
What about transmissions?
I just finished the last of them. You guys wouldn't happen to be looking for something to do during this storm, would you?
Because if you are, Vanessa and I have the perfect idea.
I'm up for anything.
Rodney and I created a game. But it's not just any game. It's filled with adventure, thrills, and intrigue. We call it
The Mountains of Wiltshire.
And we've been looking for some people to playtest it with us.
I really like games.
And this one sounds super exciting.
What do you think, Tony?
I'm not much of a gamer, but... I don't have anything else to do right now, so yeah.
Perfect. Okay, we need a few minutes to set everything up.
Harper and Jake, each of you will be on my team. We are the Mighty Grasshoppers.
Grasshoppers?
Tony and Dot, you're on my team. We are the Resolute Badgers.
Sure.
Vanessa and I will serve as your guides. We can help answer any questions you have, but we won't be able to help you along the challenges you face.
Only by relying on each other will you be able to win the game. And remember, good friends are loyal.
Before we begin, you may each choose one item from each of these boxes. Choose wisely. They will help you along your quest.
A tablet?
Pretend that's a mirror.
Very well. Are we ready to begin?
Let's do it! Very well. Both teams come to a fork in a road. There, you will meet an old woman. The first to answer her question correctly will gain an advantage. Begin.
I'm here to answer your question.
Hey, I got here first.
Oh, the Great Sky Wing. I haven't seen one of its kind in many years. This allows the competitor to gain an advantage and be faster. Ha.
So tell me, dearie, what is the best cure for an old woman's headache? Is it the root of a jasper tree or cloud soup?
Okay, I'm completely lost. Dot, I think that we should ask them.
The root of the jasper tree.
You are correct. Thank you for jogging my memory. As a reward, I will now take you to the mountains of Wiltshire. If that is where you would like to go.
Yeah, I mean, it's the name of the game, so yeah, I guess so. Yeah.
That's where we want to go.
Very well.
Mighty grasshoppers, I will lead you into the forests of Devon.
Ready, team?
Let's go.
Hey, so how did you know that the fruit from the whatever tree was the right answer?
Oh, I just guessed.
Okay, but do you think that's the best practice?
You have done well to travel this far, weary travelers. The mountains of Wiltshire are not easy to climb.
What's our next test? I'm ready.
Okay, you have to figure out a way to get into the castle of Wiltshire. You can either scale the castle walls, charter the assistance of a kindly flying horse, burrow underneath the castle, or knock on the castle's front door.
Okay, I think we should really talk about this one, okay?
But we don't want the other team to catch up with us.
I know, but we may not get as lucky this time. I think we need to ask Vanessa some questions, like, how tall is the castle wall? How much does it cost to charter a flying horse? What burrowing tools are nearby?
No way. That's going to take way too long. Okay. Vanessa!
Yes, Dot?
We're going to burrow under that wall.
Ah, very well. You begin searching for a digging site. You stumble into one of the castle's many trap doors.
Huh?
What?
In a split second, you dive deep down into the inky depths of the caves of Cheshire.
No!
So, the jungle path is easy to navigate, but filled with poisonous snakes?
That is correct.
And the path up the raging river is slippery, but walkable if we go slowly?
That is also correct.
We'll take the raging river path.
Excellent! You've both done a great job of showing that good friends are loyal by listening to each other and working together. To the raging river path. Unless...
Unless?
Jake, you possess the daring die. If you roll a 3 or higher, your progress up the path will be much quicker. However, if you fail, your progress will slow to a crawl.
You better be careful, Jake.
I'm going to try. After all, we're a ways behind the other team.
Ah, what a shame.
Sorry, Harper.
It's okay, but we need to get going.
I'm so sorry, Tony. I really messed up back there.
Oh, it's okay, Dot. I mean, we didn't know about the trapdoors.
But we could have. You wanted to ask Vanessa for help, but no. I just had to have my own way. I didn't treat you like a loyal friend. Maybe you should just leave me here.
Dot, I'm not gonna leave you in the basement.
These are the caves of Cheshire.
Oh, either way, do you want to say a Bible verse with me? Is that allowed?
You may proceed.
Sure.
It's from the book of Proverbs, chapter 17, verse 17. Here, goes like this. Proverbs 17, 17.
Proverbs 17, 17.
A friend is always loyal.
A friend is always loyal.
And a brother is born to help in time of need.
And a brother is born to help in time of need.
Good friends are loyal. They forgive each other when they mess up, and they don't turn their backs on each other when things get hard.
But why? Why are friends always loyal?
Because Jesus is loyal to us. His love for us never changes.
Right. Thanks for reminding me of that, Tony.
Now, let's see if we can get out of this basement. The cave of Cheshire.
Caves of Cheshire.
Caves, okay.
Jake, you have elected to scale the walls of the Castle of Wiltshire.
I'm gonna give it my best shot.
Harper, what will you do?
I'll watch Jake from right here.
Jake, you begin to scale the castle wall, moving quickly stone by stone. But halfway up, your clothes are caught by the invisible thorns and vines covering the walls. You're stuck!
Oh no! Harper, help! What are the chances I'll get stuck if I go up there?
Nearly 50%.
I'll try knocking on the castle door.
But what about me?
Don't worry, Jake. I'll come back for you once I win the game. You're just a little too unlucky for me to deal with right now.
Harper, you knock on the castle door, and the door swings wide open. You may proceed to your final test.
So, I'm in the castle, Rodney. What's my final test?
You come face to face with the castle's guardian, the icy Leviathan of the Cumberland Alps. It spreads its wings and flies high above your head. What do you do?
I don't know. All I have is this rope. How am I supposed to defeat whatever that thing is?
I have to admit, climbing up those caves was a lot easier than I thought.
But we figured it out together. Mm-hmm. Jake? What are you doing up here?
I tried to climb the castle wall and got stuck. My team left me here.
I'm sorry, man.
It's all right. The front door is the right way into the castle. You might be able to catch up if you leave now.
What are you talking about? First, we need to get you down off the wall.
Don't bother. You'll probably just end up getting stuck, too. I've been nothing but bad luck.
Vanessa, could I use Tony's mirror as a tablet? I'll allow it. Jake, watch this Bible link from our archives with me.
All right.
A famine came to Israel. Elimelech, Naomi, and their sons went to Moab to find food. Elimelech died. The sons married Moabite women, Orpah and Ruth. Then the sons died too. The three women had no husbands. When the famine in Israel was over, Naomi decided to go home. Stay in Moab, she said to her daughters-in-law. It's your home. Orpah stayed, but Ruth said, wherever you go, I will go. Your people will be my people. Your God will be my God. Together, Ruth and Naomi went back to Israel. It was harvest time in Israel. Naomi told Ruth to gather the bits of grain left behind in a field. The field belonged to Boaz, Elimelech's relative. Boaz approached Ruth. You were very kind to Naomi, Boaz said. Leaving home must have been hard. May God bless you. He gave Ruth food and told his workers to watch over her. Ruth told Naomi what happened. Naomi smiled. When someone dies, his closest relative cares for his family. That person is their kinsman redeemer. Boaz is our kinsman redeemer. Stay close to him. So Ruth stayed close to Boaz. He liked her more each day. Boaz bought Elimelech's land and took care of Naomi and Ruth. Then he asked Ruth to marry him. Ruth had a son called Obed. Obed's son was Jesse. Jesse's son was David. And David became Israel's greatest king. So God blessed Ruth just as Boaz had prayed.
Ruth could have gone home instead of staying with Naomi. But she was Naomi's friend, and friends stick together even when times are tough.
Even when friends are on different teams?
Even when friends are on different teams, good friends are loyal.
So, how are we gonna get Jake down? I don't think the Great Sky Wing will be much help.
Oh, I know. We can use the reflection in the mirror, and we can see the invisible vines and thorns that are holding Jake, and we can help Jake free himself.
While that's not the typical use of the sea glass mirror, it is a solution I will allow.
Really?
Tony, you did it! Jake will have you down in no time.
Harper, are you all right?
Jake, I'm so sorry I left you behind. I thought I could do it on my own, but I can't. I was a bad friend. Will you forgive me?
Of course.
Hey, why are we hiding behind the console?
Because there's a Leviathan flying overhead.
What are we gonna do?
Well, I have this rope I could use to tie the Leviathan up, but I can't reach it as long as it's flying.
Vanessa, what would happen if I rolled the daring die right now?
There's a 33% chance the Leviathan would fall asleep, but you'd have to roll a 1 or a 6.
I'm not sure I should chance it. It might just make things worse.
The Leviathan of the Cumberland Alps spots the castle's intruders.
If it does, we'll figure out another way, because we're a team.
The
Leviathan comes crashing down to the castle floor.
Oh, Harper, don't forget your rope.
Right. I use the rope to tie the Leviathan in place.
You've defeated the Leviathan and restored peace to the mountains of Wiltshire!
Congratulations, you guys! You did it!
I can't believe that worked.
Rodney, Vanessa, that game was amazing.
Thanks.
We're so glad you liked it.
And we couldn't have beaten it without our loyal friends.
Hi, I'm Harper, and I'm part of Connect HQ. I have a verse to share with you. Say it with me like this. Proverbs 17, 17. A friend is always loyal, and a brother is born to help in time of need. Good friends don't turn their back on you and are always there for you when you need it. When Ruth and Naomi's husbands died, Ruth could have returned home to her parents, but she didn't. She was a loyal friend and stayed with Naomi even when times were tough. Look for ways to be there for your friends. If they're sad or upset, listen to them. If bad things are happening to them, be there for them. If they've made a mistake or hurt your feelings, forgive them. We can be loyal friends because Jesus is a loyal friend to us. He gave us the best example to follow. Don't ever forget, good friends are loyal. And remember, Connect HQ is here to help you.
So who had the original idea for the game?
I did.
Vanessa, you know the Mountains of Wiltshire was my idea.
Maybe that one tiny part, creating the world of the game, but the gameplay was something I created.
The gameplay, but that doesn't mean it was your idea.
Well, creating the world of the game doesn't mean it was yours either.
You guys?
Grasshoppers, come with me.
Oh, that's how it is? Badgers, you're with me.
What's going on?
Are you two fighting?
Yes!
How did you make a lasso? Where's the end of it? Hold on. I'm not sure I'm doing this right.
Sometimes we all feel lonely, but no matter what, Jesus will always be here for you. He's the most loyal friend you could ask for. If you want to be friends with Jesus, you can make that choice today. All you have to remember are the ABCs. A, admit. Admit that you've done wrong and ask God to forgive you for disobeying him. B, believe. Believe God sent Jesus to take the punishment for your sin. Trust that you're forgiven because Jesus made you right with God. C, choose. Choose to spend your whole life depending on God's power to help you say no to sin. As you live and love like Jesus, tell others God is your leader and number one friend. Did you make that decision today? If so, be sure to talk about it with a parent or a leader you trust.
Church kids, this week, let's challenge ourselves to resolve conflicts with grace and forgiveness, just as Jesus taught us.
Even when it might be hard, let's pray and ask God to help us resolve conflicts in a way that honors him and brings healing to our relationships.
We'll see you next week. And don't forget, it's a great day
to be a church kid! Yeah!
Resolving conflicts!
Church kids, in case you didn't know, we wanted to tell you that Jesus loves you. Yes, you. And he loves you so much that he died on the cross for your sins so that we could have salvation, which means we are in right standing with God. When we ask Jesus into our heart to be the leader and Lord of our life, we no longer have to walk in fear or in shame because when God sees us, he sees the righteousness of his son, Jesus. Salvation is a free gift to anyone who says yes to Jesus. In fact, in Romans 10:9, it says this, if you declare with your mouth, Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. So if today you want to make the decision to make Jesus the leader and Lord of your life, now is your moment. Are you ready? As a sign of support, let's all pray this together. Lord Jesus, welcome to my world. I ask you to come into my heart and to forgive me of all of my sins. I decide today to follow you and to make you the leader and Lord of my life. I believe it, I receive it, and I will never be the same again. In Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer for the first time, we are so excited for you. Make sure to tell a church kids leader so we can celebrate with you and give you next steps.